So I'm here with Lloyd Russell-Moyle. Can't say MP because we're in an election period now. So just give us an update, really, on the constituency issues that you've been working on recently. I know Moscombe Primary School is something that I've been working... been talking to a lot of parents, actually, who are very vocal and very... very organised and very passionate.
I think the parents of Moscombe have been fighting hard for that school. Look, we've got a number of issues in Moscombe, not just about the school, but about the changing demographics, families moving out, and the schools having less and less people going to both Bevendine and Moscombe.
Yeah.
And Moscombe parents and the community have worked darn hard in making sure that school stays afloat, stays alive, and they provide an excellent education for the children there. Many parents now come from across the city to go to Moscombe because they know it's the only school that will provide their children with the special educational needs, the sensory needs, or the other issues that other schools aren't able to do because of these awful cuts from the Conservative government. And last year, the Conservatives cut the number of support staff that Moscombe was entitled to have. They cut their funding, and we had to say goodbye to a number of support staff, but still the community rallied around.
Yeah.
And so that's why it was absolutely gutting when Ofsted came and gave a bad report of Moscombe, despite their results improving and despite them doing everything that was in the last report. They changed the goalposts in the most unfair way, in a politically motivated way, because if you fail a school, you can flog a school off, you can sell it to an academy chain, and those parents are determined not to let that happen, because we know what happens with lots of academies. Not all. There are some good academies. I mean, you've got a good little school in Whitehawk, for example, but most academies will just push the troubled children out. The children that need a bit of extra help. And many of us need a bit of extra help in different parts of our educational process.
Yeah.
Anyone that needs a bit more work, they can go away. And they're excluded and they're ignored. And we know 50,000 children across the UK were excluded from academies and other schools just last year. This is disgraceful what's happening. And they want to do that to Moscombe. And so I'm so delighted that the parents have fought back. The parents have managed to fight off two academy sponsors now. One of the academy sponsors complained to me that the parents were protesting outside. And they said, oh, it wasn't very nice, that's why we decided not to come here. Well, I say well done to those parents. I can't be more proud of what they've done. I think it really shows that you don't mess with a good working class community like Moscombe. Now, unfortunately, the Secretary of State and the Conservative government have said that in February, if they're still in power, it will now go to a private academy chain.
And so, just very briefly, with the campaign, you're going to be out very busy in the next few weeks, 12th of December. So it's full time.
Oh, it's full time go. Yeah. You know, kind of 12th of December. What happens between now and the 12th of December? So at the moment, we're in the process of door knocking.
Yeah.
So you might find me disturbing you late one evening.
Yeah.
In the next
I'll probably be in the studio for yeah.
Well, I look, I always feel sorry for people if we disturb them, but I say it's only for a few weeks and then you can go back to your normal life and enjoy Christmas. And I'm looking forward to enjoying Christmas.
Yeah.
And then we will start delivering some leaflets.
Yeah.
You will see information out on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram if you use it. And then you will see direct mail letters from me. You said you'd already received one around my Brexit positions and what my views are on there. And on the back of it, you will have seen all the stuff that we're going to do for house building and rebuilding our country. So we're going to get all those messages out there. We're going to have lots of hustings. I'm going to do one at Sussex University. We're going to do one in Rottingdean. We're going to do one hopefully at the Bevy or at Moscombe Primary, I think.
Yeah.
We're going to try and do that now. And we're going to do all of that. And I hope after the election, I hope that I win. I hope that the people continue their trust in me. But more importantly, I hope we can get to business in starting to rebuild this country, because Britain deserves better, Brighton deserves better, and we can do it together.
We'll leave it there for now. Lloyd, all the best for the campaign. I love a good election, so I'm looking forward to it myself.
And
as
you're going to be there on the count, aren't you?
I'm
with Facebook Live.
Yes.
And, yeah.
Well, I will be there.
You'll be there for the excitement. Well, I hope the viewers will be there for the excitement as well.
Perfect. We'll leave it there.
Cheers. Thank you very much.